Hello, everyone. I hope you're keeping cool. Enjoy the nice weather. It's not going to last forever. This week's subject is different uses for money gifts. Maybe you've received a very nice monetary gift and you don't know what to do with the money. We are glad that you're being careful about using it, and we suggest some following considerations for your new funds. Prioritize your long and short-term goals. Goals should be realistic and specific. Your goals are the guidelines for what to do with money. For example, if you'd like to purchase a house in the near future, the money might represent a down payment. Money to be used in the short term should be held in a more conservative investment than money needed further down the road. What about establishing an emergency reserve, a fund for unexpected expenses? Most financial advisors recommend 3 to 6 months of living expenses as an emergency reserve in case something happens and you need it. If you're self-employed, you may want more of an emergency reserve just in case business slacks off for a little bit of time. Money set aside for this purpose should also be accessible and kept conservative. What about the long-term retirement funding? The earlier one starts saving for retirement, the better off he or she will be when retirement arrives. Depending upon your needs, you might consider contributing to a traditional or Roth IRA. You'll need to review your eligibility requirements for these plans before making contributions. If your employer offers a retirement plan such as a 401k or 403b, consider swapping dollars. By that, use the money to live while you increase the contributions through your payroll into the plan. This can help go a long way toward your retirement. Buying a house, like we mentioned earlier, this might represent that down payment on a home. Before you buy, consider all the aspects of home ownership. The monthly mortgage payment is only part of the total expense involved in owning a home. Factor in costs such as home maintenance, repairs, and insurance. Consider how long you might live at this location. In the end, you have to decide if home ownership is the right path for you. What about debt? If you receive an inheritance and you have a lot of debt, you may want to work toward chipping that away. I recommend paying the highest interest rate debt first. Doing some research and reading some books on personal finance and having your long-term goals and objectives can be very important here, because the more you know about where you're heading financially or where you and your spouse are heading financially, the better decisions you can make, especially if you receive an unexpected lump sum of money. And don't forget, life is about balance. Don't spend it all on the emergency reserve, but then don't spend it all on a vacation either. You may want to balance things out, have a little fun today, but put some money away for tomorrow.